I welcome you here this morning. I've known Tammy and I've known Jerry, I've known Kylie, I've known the family for a number of years. And this is something I never had pictured myself doing. I don't think any of you pictured yourselves being here on a sunny morning in January to come together and to grieve together, to mourn the loss of someone so special to us in such an unexpected way. My name is Deacon Dale. I'm a deacon at St. John the Baptist Catholic Church in Draper. I met Kylie when she was about 13 or 14 years old, along with her sister Brittany and Tammy, and they had come to be baptized in our church. And in our church, it takes a while. It takes at least 9 months, almost a year, before we do a baptism, because we want people to understand what they're asking for and whether this is really something that they're looking for in their lives. And sometimes with the younger ones, we wonder, even when they can say that this is what I want, whether or not that's what they're really asking for. And I think in Kai's situation, it was indeed something that she wanted. And I'm going to talk about that a little bit more a little later. I was asked not to be too churchy today. That's like asking Kai not to be a free spirit. So I will share a little bit of my faith, but it's also a chance today for us to share a whole lot of memories. So we're going to begin with an opening song, "I'll Never Be the Same." Or maybe not. You know, last night when I was preparing for this, my computer stopped working. And I thought, Kai, what are you doing to me? And I think in a way that she has to make her presence known here. Like I said, this is not an easy thing. But that's okay. Life is never easy. Tammy asked me a very good question this morning. Deacon, you're so close to God. Why? And it's not the first time a mother's had to ask me that question. I wish it had been, but it's not. It happens. We're born, we're on a journey. We never know exactly where that road's going to take us, but we end up somewhere where we all end up eventually. So since we don't have the song, I think we'll just go ahead and we're going to start with Tammy. So Tammy, if you want to come up, and I know you have much you want to share with us.
Thank you guys all for coming. And if one thing was not known about my daughter is that she liked drama. And here is a proof of it. This is the proof of the chaos and drama that she needed to create even to her very last day with us. My beautiful baby girl and my sweet baby, the most amazing smile and the biggest dimples you could have ever missed. A laugh and a scream that you would never forget. The bluest eyes that matched the perfect blue sky of the day. And the strength and the courage that you could never, ever, ever known. And the kindest and lovingest heart that will never, ever be able to be replaced has left us all because of this horrible monster of ALS. Kylie was a true free spirit that always danced to her own beat. Most of the time after either being in shock, mad, or just lost for words, I eventually learned to look at all of these lessons, mistakes, and boy, the tests that she gave me by either laughing and smiling and just keeping a warm heart with her. I was told and I learned that replacing them with happiness, kindness, joy, instead of anger, frustration, was a healthier way of processing all of this. Kylie and I always had such a unique relationship that most people would have never understood. A lot of people couldn't even accept it. But it was ours. And it was beautiful. And it was beautiful to us. I think that our souls, because of that connection and that love for each other, knew that we were just going to have a short time together. And that we didn't have much time, so we had to pack everything that we could do and be together in this short time. There was many days in the last few months of laying in bed with her and just sitting there talking with her and reminiscing about our lives and our times together and all of our memories. And I can tell you that her and I truly did not have any regrets with each other. Our love for each other and our peace was pure. I truly feel broken right now, and I know someday I'll feel a little bit better. But I have lost my best friend, my little mini-me, my dancing partner, my partner in crime, and then the only one that would go get Mitty and pities with me. I can't imagine after today not being able to touch her and see her physically. I know she'll be with me always and forever, and I am blessed and so grateful that she picked me to be her mom and her warrior. And to go through this hell of a warrior journey with her with this ALS. I know that she was able to slay that monster the way she wanted to and how she wanted to. There was a quote that I kept having after shortly after she was diagnosed that kept coming to me because I was reading this grieving book, and it says, "I keep looking for you everywhere. I can feel you and I can smell you, but I just can't find you or see you. I'm so scared and I miss you and I love you so much. I don't know from this point how everything will go or how it will look, but I do know I will miss my baby so much. I know that we'll be with each other in heart and in soul forever. I thank you guys all so much for coming and supporting and loving us through this journey. Thank you.
Thank you, Tammy. Thank you for sharing that. No one can see their children better than the eyes of their mother. And such beautiful memories, and such tragedy too. Let's now share this musical selection, Talking to My Angel.
Thank you. Like to invite Eli up, please.
All the memories with me and Kai will forever be in my heart. Now I will say a poem. Don't remember me with sadness, don't remember me with tears. Remember all the laughter we've shared throughout the years. I am contented that my life is worthwhile, knowing that I passed along the way and made someone smile. When you are walking down the street and you've got me on your mind, I'm walking in your footsteps, only half a step behind. So please don't be unhappy just because I'm out of sight. Remember that I'm with you each morning, noon, and night. Thank you.
Thank you, Eli. That was beautiful. What we'd like to do right now is to open up the mic for anybody that would like to share a memory. It's difficult, I know, for some of us. It's hard to get up and speak before others. If you're not able to right now, you can share it with Tammy or Jerry or myself or just another one of our friends later on. But if you have something that you would like to share now with all of us, we'll open the mic to you.
I know most of you. I'm Josh, Kai's older brother, which is an honor to be the oldest brother of Kai, Britt, my broski, Mike, and just be part of this family. I'll keep this brief so everybody can have some time up here, but, you know, reflecting back the last couple weeks and getting to be part of Kai's journey, the end, going toward the end of her life was a lot of emotion, as you can imagine, but it was also very beautiful in a way, and I had a lot of memories growing up with her, and they were mostly laughter, and like people do behind their parents' backs, we make fun of them and laugh and vent it out together, right? I go through so many moments with Kai when I think back through just growing up to her 21st birthday and Wendover, which is wild times, and just watching her develop into an adult was wonderful, and something I hadn't gotten to experience before as a brother. So, Kai, I love you, and at least I got to have a last laugh, and I'll share that story. Was during her celebration of life, many of you were there. Brittany helped me through a tough moment of what to say to her, and because I didn't know how to say that to a person that was leaving, and so I just got into bed with her, and she wasn't feeling well, and she was tired, and if you know the movie, you'll understand, and I just kind of held her, and I just said, some people talking about people, and she ripped the sheets back and looked at me and sang the other part of the song with a big smile, and I'll never forget that. And I get to leave with that and be content that we had that last laugh together. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for your support and your love. And I'll open this up. And I love you, and I love you. Love you, Kai, and you'll always be in my heart.
Oh God, I hate this so much. So I'm Mike, also Kylie's older brother. I don't know how I'm supposed to follow Eli's touching poem, but so I'll keep it brief as well. The last couple of weeks have made me extremely happy for Kylie, even through all the sadness, because Kylie loved to bring people together. And that's what this experience has done for all of us. Specifically our family, and not that any of you aren't, but it's something we needed, and it was secretly Kylie's last wish to me that she expressed. One of the things about bringing people together is Kylie also loved a compliment or two, and she was guaranteed to get a couple with her beauty or with her remarks or whatever way she attracted it was going to come towards her, and she deserved all of the compliments she could ever receive. I was lucky enough to watch Kylie grow up for almost 15 years. She really grew into an amazing human being. One that I cared for very much. One thing Kylie did grow into was something that I've learned she cared very much about, and that's a sunflower. And she grew into a beautiful sunflower. I don't know why I was, why I wanted to look into it, but I found some things that Kylie shared with the sunflower as well. So, I mean, to start off, I guess 2021, the last year of Kylie's life, was the year of the sunflower. I didn't know if she knew that, but it was. Looking into it a little more, this is a little technical, so don't get mad at my grammar or bad reading, but sunflowers are called what's heliotropic, which means that they turn their flowers to follow the movement of the sun each day from east to west, and then at night return to the east and go to sleep to do it again the next day. That was Kylie, especially these last years. She followed the sun. She was always guaranteed to wake up the next morning, even though she knew inevitably it wouldn't happen one day, but she still followed the sun each day, and she fought hard so that she could. I guess a part of being heliotropic is inevitably your seeds get too heavy for you to carry on anymore. And that was Kylie's fate with ALS, but all of us being here can help carry that weight for her and her memory. That's all I have to say. I love you guys. Everyone's support's awesome. Well, one thing I have to say for Kylie, it's not funny, but it's just true. She was an amazing aunt, an amazing daughter, an amazing sister. So I love her, I miss her.
So for those that don't know me, I am a very dear family friend. My kids look at Jerry as Uncle Jerry, look at Tammy as Aunt Tammy, and I have come to know the family as my family. I came to know Kylie as a beautiful, beautiful, if I had one word to describe Kylie as courageous, she knew what she wanted. She knew what she wanted in life. She was a happy, happy girl. I would remember the day at the apartment where we were playing games and ordered food and played like there was nothing. That she always respected. On her last celebration of life, right before she was wheeled by her mother and friends to her room, I looked at her and I says, I love you. And she looked at me and she goes, tell the girls I love them. And those are my daughters. She's only about a few months in age from my youngest one. But the happiness she brought, I would say we all overlook the happiness in terms of sadness. But I think she gave us, if you were to put on a scale and try to balance that scale, I think we had more good days with Kylie than we ever did bad. So we would dwell on that as individuals, as friends, as parents, as uncles, as aunts, to what a beautiful person she was, and what a beautiful person she still is, because she's not here in person in life, but she's here in memories with us, and as such, she's still with us. I will forever be grateful to have been associated with Kylie and the family. That's all.
Anyone else?
I'm Brittany, for those of you who don't know me, Kylie's sister. Originally, I wasn't going to come up here and say anything because I don't like talking in front of people. But my son kind of talked me into it. He's like, Mom, you have to say something. But I'm unprepared, and you know, my mom told me to just say what comes to your heart, but like all I can think about is just like how much I miss Kai. So I'm just gonna read the poem that me and my mom picked out. When tomorrow starts without me, please try to understand that an angel come and called my name and took me by the hand. The angel said my place was ready in heaven far above. And that I'd have to leave behind all those I dearly love. But when I walked through heaven's gates, I felt so much at home, where God looked down, smiled at me, and told me, welcome home. So when tomorrow starts without me, don't think we're far apart, for every time you think of me, I'm right there in your heart.
talk, but I think Kylie wanted me to. I haven't known Kylie for very long. My name is Elisa Watson. My father also passed away to us, so we made a bond there. I wouldn't say bond, I say I weaseled my way into their family. Because I knew that I would just instantly love them, and I did. I've been trying to think of what Kylie would like me to say. I definitely have clear directions from her. I think I made her intentions pretty clear. And right before she passed, she told me to have self-compassion, which is something I never imagined learning from someone much younger than me. And to also look after that bee. She made sure of it. I don't know how many times she asked me to. So I got you, Tammy. I've been just picking out a few memories that we had in our very short time together. The first time I ever met them, that I finally got to come over, I was so excited and nervous, and you never know what to say. But I came over and she was making an easy bake oven dessert. And I was like, what is happening? And I asked her, I was like, okay, like this is where we're at. And she's like, yeah, I never had one growing up. So I just always wanted to do that. And I was like, okay. And she shared with me the dessert. And we both were like, this is not super good. But I just, yeah, that is something that I really just, yeah, I think about a lot. Tammy was really brave, and she let April, my sister, and I take Kylie to the zoo because we were trying to fill her days with some happiness. It was really special on the way back from the zoo. Well, first of all, Kylie bought 2 stuffed animals from the zoo, and you know how expensive those are, and I was like, Tammy's gonna kill me. I'm bringing her back with these stuffed animals, and we let her get burned, and I just, yeah, we didn't do a very good job. But but driving in the car back to the house to drop her off, it was kind of the first time her and I got to just kind of be alone and talk. And we got to talk about the fears and the concerns and like all of the really beautiful things that she was looking forward to. And that was really special to me too. I'm really going to miss shit talking with her. That was our favorite thing to do. I would just come over and just let her talk, and she would let me talk, and we had a really fun friendship. We got to talk a lot about my dad. I was there to just kind of help her. Even though they had really different paths, we got to talk about maybe what that looked like for her. She really loved this poem, so I thought if it's okay that I share it. This is from Thich Nhat Hanh. This body is not me. I am not caught in this body. I am life without boundaries. I have never been born and I have never died. Over there, the white ocean and sky with many galaxies, all manifest from the basis of consciousness. Since beginningless time, I have always been free. Birth and death are only a door which we go in and out. Birth and death are only a game of hide and seek. So smile and wave to me and take my hand. Tomorrow we shall meet again, or even before. We shall always be meeting again at the true source. Always meeting again on the myriad paths of life. I'm just grateful for you guys to have me be a part of her life. I'm gonna miss her a lot. I love you guys. Thank you.
My name is April, and I was lucky enough to be Kylie's friend through the last part of her journey. Sorry. I just want to share a couple of things I learned from her. I learned take every opportunity to buy those stuffed animals. They're so soft and adorable, and they're a hug anytime you want it. It's brilliant. I don't know why adults don't get it. It's awesome. I learned there just isn't time. None of us really have enough time. Kylie showed me that if you feel safe, go ahead and just fall in love with a new friend. Her hugs are the best. I learned being a bad bitch is a good thing. I did not know that. I learned that being an aunt is the best possible role in life. Her love for her nieces and nephews was uncomplicated and a bridge right to her heart. I learned don't define yourself by one thing. It's best if you own just being a really complicated human. You know, she picked sunflowers, mermaids, Cruella de Vil, Disney villain, rose quartz stones, dragonflies, so many things to represent her. I learned that a mother's love can move mountains. When I first walked into Tammy and Jerry's home, I noticed every single medical device, every single item that was meant to bring more mobility and comfort and a degree of normalcy for Kylie. Having been through a dad with ALS, I know that each one of these items represents the immense burden on finance, the boldness of just getting on your knees and begging a healthcare system to help you when there's not much to offer, the supreme kindness of others who walked this path before you, who donate in an endless round of multiplying love. Each item represents sacrifice. Each item, each sleepless night, each time you did something for her that she couldn't do for herself, that was a stone moved in the mountain of ALS. On my last visit with Kylie, I learned there are better things to say than I'm sorry. I'd been saying it to her because I didn't know what else to say. And she looked me right in the eyes in that really direct Kylie way. And she said, just say, I see you, I hear you, and I love you. Thanks for the lessons, Kylie. I love you.
I can speak in front of a gazillion high school students, but we'll see how this goes. I'm Deanna Smith. I was the principal when Kylie started high school. So you can only imagine the drama I got to go through with her and the amount of time Tammy and I spent together crying, laughing, and plotting. Little did we know she was plotting behind our backs. I heard a lot about the siblings, and it's really awesome to meet you guys in person. I'm sorry it's today. She loved you guys. Mom, you know she loved you. I don't want to say regret, but I'm sad that I missed a big chunk of her life, but I'm glad I got to come in at the end. I am shaking. I read a story to my daughter right as I was finding out about Kylie, and Kylie welcomed me into her room on that last day, and she let me read it to her. And it was an amazing way to say goodbye. And Tammy, I'm sorry. I know you're not supposed to say you're sorry, but I am as a mom. And I wasn't a mom when I met Kylie. And then Kylie got to hold my firstborn son. And there's just things that you'll never forget, and that will be one of them. I love you with my whole heart, Kylie. That's what my family says. And I know that you have your wings. I love you. I love you guys.
brief, but I'm not good at talking in public. I never do that. I've known Kylie a short amount of months. I was her caregiver. She was like a blessing in my life. You know, I go in there and I met her and we just clicked. And from that day, like my first day there, you know, they asked for me back and permanently. And I thought I was taking care of her, and ironically, it was the other way around. She showed me true friendship and strength I've never seen before. She was an amazing person, and she cared so much about her family. She cared about everyone, family, friends. She was just a whole nother being. I always looked for like a friendship, like the one I got with her. I always wanted someone in my life who just unconditionally loved you for your mistakes and every imperfection, and she truly showed me what friendships are. And I'm so blessed I had all of you and got to meet all of you, and you guys are an amazing family. I hear about you guys all the time. She loves her grandkids, or her nieces, not grandkids. She loves her nieces and nephews. I tried my best to make her last few months amazing. We watched Cruella de Vil countless of times. And we discussed conspiracy theories on how mermaids are real. She was just truly a blessing. And when I see the sunsets or anything like that, I definitely will think of her and all the beautiful power and light she gave to everyone in their lives. And I just want to leave off with a quote. I've been reading this book, and in the quote it said, grief is hard and most of us just want it to end, but it's best to find comfort knowing that grief will end when it needs to, not when you want it to. And that's it. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you all for coming. I'm Jerry, and I hope you all see this wonderful video and listen to the soundtrack that went along with it, because those are all very special songs. To Kai, so I was using that as my inspiration for a few words about Kai. So first of all, straight from the heart, my child, my daughter. Honored to have been. The father in your life. And I wish you'd get up right now and tell me to get out of your room and don't touch me. I miss you. And I hope you're under the sea. Kind of, I spent a lot of time in the water, on it, and under it. It was very special to her. And she has her legs now. And I hope that she's using them to swim around with the dolphins that she loves so much. And if you didn't know this, Kai was a Titanic scholar. She loved the story of the Titanic. And in the show, The Titanic, there was this song that was very special to her. And near, far, wherever you are. Your heart goes on with me. I miss you and I love you. And Kai has been yelling in my ear this whole time because it is so important to acknowledge. She's an amazing, wonderful woman that stood by her and walked through unbelievable fire with her. And having been there, standing behind and watching Tammy, you're amazing. Thank you for that. And I can't say enough about that. The sacrifices that Tam made, and willingly, happily, and lovingly. So thank you. Thank all of you that were on the journey with us. Brittany, through it all, wonderful sister. Being such a strength and support and a beacon for Kai. Josh and Mike, thank you for the love and support that you gave her. Eli and Eleanor, for her special little angels. And little Brea. Always brought so much happiness to her and the horrible pain. And in closing, if you need a cause moving forward, find a way to deal with this ALS, Lou Gehrig syndrome. She would want that because the people that have this horrible disease need so much. So if you want a cause to get behind, this is one. Thank you all. I'm sorry, Lisa and April, you were very special. And we truly appreciate all the love and support and comfort that you brought to our daughter. So thank you. And I love you guys. Again, I could thank everyone in the room. Thank you from the bottom of our heart. Kai thanks you. I love you all.
To share a little bit more music with you now. The song Calling All Angels.
Thank you.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shade of the Almighty, say to the Lord, my refuge and fortress, my God in whom I trust. He will rescue you from the fowler's snare. He will shelter you with his pinions, and under his wings you may take refuge. His faithfulness is a protecting shield. You shall not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. You need simply watch, because you have the Lord as your refuge, and you have made the Most High your stronghold. He commands his angels with regard to you, to guard you wherever you go. With their hands they shall support you, lest you strike your foot against a stone. They that hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on eagle's wings. Kylie, that's the 91st Psalm. It became a great song for us in a modern era called On Eagle's Wings. But in that 91st Psalm, eagle's wings is never mentioned. That was something that was added by the composer. They took it from the book of Isaiah. You know, we're surprised sometimes that some things seem incomplete without that little bit of extra. My life would be incomplete without Kylie being that little bit of extra. Just like your lives would be incomplete without her. I often speak to high school students when they're about to graduate, and I tell them, you're going to go into this world and you're going to make a difference. It'll be your choice how you make the difference. You make a difference for good, you make a difference for not so good. And for all of us, I think Kylie. Kai made a difference for good. I mentioned her baptism, and I'll just say one more little word about that, because the vestments that I'm wearing today, these clothes that I'm wearing today, are the same clothes that I wear at baptism. And they're the same clothes I wear when I come to a funeral. Because these are the clothes we were given to wear, the white, as part of our faith. The white is to show our life here on earth, beginning to end. But then a new life begins. Without my certain faith in that, this life would be totally meaningless. It would just be mass chaos. It would just be everyone for themselves. But this is just leading up to something incredible. Tammy, I can't answer your question of why Kylie only got 27 years, but there were 27 good years in which she had a chance to make a difference, and she did. At baptism, she's given a sign, an indelible mark on her soul, that she will always be recognized for that faith that she had in that moment. And even though she struggled in the last years with her faith, that faith will be recognized by God and should be raised up on eagle's wings. And though we part from her, we will see her again. When the Lord, who sent his Son to destroy death, will destroy the deaths of all, so that we will all rise again. So I'm going to close with two prayers. The first prayer is for Kylie. Holy Lord, Almighty and Eternal God, hear our prayers for your servant, Kai, whom you've summoned out of this world. Forgive her sins and failings and grant her a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Let her pass unharmed through the gates of death to dwell with the blessed in light, as you promised to Abraham and his children forever. Accept Kylie into your safekeeping, and on the great day of judgment, raise her up with all the saints to inherit your eternal kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, the most important one at this moment, I think, is the prayer for you. Father of mercies and God of all consolation, you pursue us with untiring love and dispel the shadow of death with the bright light of dawn. Comfort your family in their loss and sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength, O Lord, and lift us from the depths of grief into the peace and light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying, destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Enable us, therefore, to press on toward him, so that after our earthly course is run, he may reunite us with those we love, when every tear will be wiped away. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let me close now with "Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Me."
Thank you, Deacon Dale. On behalf of Kylie's parents and her siblings, I want to sincerely thank everybody for being patient with us and attending. While we are having the closing song, we would invite anybody, if they would like to come and approach Kylie's coffin, they can do so, and that will conclude the services. The families respectfully ask that everybody go ahead and depart. We'll be having a private closing, and if you can allow for that, that would be great. At this time, we'll conclude with a closing song. Thank you.
Yeah. Ha, 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 ha.